Okay, I just called down to daycare. Aiden is ready and waiting.
Yeah, you know what? You've had a really long day. Why don't we just get some takeout from Kelly's?
No. You are going to get a home-cooked meal. Aiden's going to be so excited you're coming home with us.
That smile is irresistible.
Thanks for being so involved. It really makes a difference even at this young age.
Well, I intend to be the best father I can be. Sleep.
Oh, great. Thank you for putting him down. Geez, the house is so quiet with Aiden asleep and the boys at Graham's. I thought maybe we could trade in the pureed carrots for some Cabernet.
Yeah. Thank you. Dinner was wonderful.
Good. I'm glad you liked it.
Well, I really appreciate the way you're sharing Aiden with me.
He's your son too, Nicholas. You can see him whenever you want.
It's good to know.
Sound awfully formal.
Sorry, it's just a bad habit, I guess.
I hope we don't always feel this distant. I know we've both made a lot of mistakes, but I thought we could put them behind us. I mean, come on, we've been friends forever. I was kind of hoping we could build on that.
I always regret the way I destroyed you and Lucky. Some of the worst things I've ever done.
No. Lucky and I were already in serious trouble, or nothing would have ever happened between you and me. And we agreed that we weren't going to feel guilty for the rest of our lives. I'm ready to move on.
Good, I think we all are. Lucky and I are at least civil with one another, and he seems happy with Siobhan.
Yeah, so I've noticed.
Carrying around all this guilt isn't good for anyone, especially the boys. You gotta focus on the future.
Right, I'm really glad you said that, because I have an idea. Here, look.
You're not reading the boys' Greek mythology.
Granted, I've had to tailor some of the stories, but Cameron is so into it all of a sudden.
I know. I was when I was his age. I remember my uncle took me on a tour of all the Greek islands one summer, and we had a great time. I'm sure I've got some pictures lying around somewhere.
Okay, so I was thinking, why don't we all take a trip to Greece for spring break? Cameron would love to see the places where these stories happen. And remember you said maybe one day we could all go together?
I did.
So what do you say? It'll be fun. Come on, we could all use a break from Port Charles. I could start researching tours for the kids, or you could plan the whole thing. It wouldn't make a difference to me. It would just be so much fun.
Hey, oh my God, I'm so sorry. It's so cold out there. Look, you guys are never gonna believe this, but I got a flat tire and it just happened to be right in front of your house.
This tow truck is taking forever.
The dispatcher said they were busy.
Yeah, but this is so embarrassing. I mean, I thought that snow tires were supposed to be, you know, tough.
They almost never go flat.
I know, but this one did, and I was on Sutton Street. You know what that's like. I mean, I was afraid to get out of my car. It was like I was praying and praying, just please, please let me get to the gas station. But I started hearing that squeaky noise, and I just knew it was the rim, and you can't drive on the rim, so stuck.
And you just happened to land right out front of my house? That's amazing.
I know. Well, I tried to change it myself, but it's not like I'm wearing, you know, sensible shoes.
Oh, my God. Okay. I've got to go pick up the boys from my grandmother's house. So, Nicholas, you want to come with me? I'm sure the boys would love to see you.
Yeah, I don't want to wake up Aiden right now.
Oh, he won't wake up. He's just popping in his car seat.
I don't want him out in this cold.
Yeah, it's freezing outside.
I'm happy to wait here until you get back. I can see the boys then.
Okay, that's fine. Maybe we could finish our evening then.
Drive carefully. So it's a good thing that tire didn't go flat in the middle of nowhere.
So what'd you use? Knife or an ice pick?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I guess it would be an ice pick. Yeah.
Oh, maybe I ran over a nail.
Right. Come on, you punctured your own tire to sabotage my dinner with Elizabeth.
Oh, okay, you know, not that I'm admitting to anything, because I'm not. But yeah, I don't, you know, I don't like the way she manipulates you, and I don't really think it's fair the way that she uses her baby. And so maybe, just maybe, I maneuvered things so that I could come to your rescue.
What makes you think I need rescuing?
Oh, do you think Elizabeth will mind if we have more wine? Let's finish it.
Might as well.
So, do you want to hit up that sushi place when she gets back?
You are impossible.
I'm impossible? Well, you were sure damn happy to see me, so.